Father.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Grace and peace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the fellowship of the Holy Spirit, be with all of you.
And with your spirit.
Minds and our hearts open to the journey during Lent. Become more familiar with our God. Place Him first in our lives, and when we don't, call upon His grace and mercy. Came to show us the path to the Father. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Came to understand that we are sinful. Would you forgive our sins? Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Came to die on the cross so that you could resurrect like all of us in our own death. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on every one of us. Forgive us of our sins, bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. O God, who have commanded us to listen to your beloved Son, be pleased, we pray, to nourish us inwardly by your word, that with spiritual sight made pure, we may rejoice to behold your glory. We ask this through Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, ever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of Genesis. God put Abraham to the test. He called to him, Abraham. Here I am, he replied. Then God said, take your son Isaac, your only one whom you love, and go to the land of Moriah. There you shall offer him up as a holocaust on a height that I will point out to you. When they came to the place of which God had told him, Abraham built an altar there and arranged the wood on it. Then he reached out and took the knife to slaughter his son. But the Lord's messenger called to him from heaven, Abraham, Abraham. Here I am, he answered. Do not lay your hand on the boy, said the messenger. Do not do the least thing to him. I know now how devoted you are to God, since you did not withhold from me your own beloved son. As Abraham looked about, he spied a ram caught by its horns in the thicket. So he went and took up the ram and offered it up as a holocaust in place of his son. Again, the Lord's messenger called to Abraham from heaven and said, I swear by myself, declares the Lord, that because you acted as you did and not withholding from me your beloved son. I will bless you abundantly and make your descendants as countless as the stars of the sky and the sands of the seashore. Your descendants shall take possession of the gates of their enemies, and in your descendants all the nations of the earth shall find blessing. All this because you obeyed my command. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Second reading is from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Brothers and sisters, if God is for us, who can be against us? He who did not spare his own son, but handed him over for us all, how will he not also give us everything else along with him? Who will bring a charge against God's chosen ones? It is God who acquits us. Who will condemn? Christ Jesus it is who died, or rather was raised, who also is at the right hand of God, who indeed intercedes for us. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Spirit.
Reading from the Holy Gospel
with you, Lord.
Jesus took Peter, James, and John and led them up on a high mountain apart from the others. And he transfigured before them his dazzling clothes with white, such as no polar on earth could be bleached. Then Elijah appeared to them among with Moses, and they were conversing with Jesus. Peter said to Jesus, replied, Rabbi, it is good that we are here. Let us make three tents, one for you, one for Moses, one for Elijah. He hardly knew what to say, that they were so terrified. And the cloud came, casting a shadow over them. When the cloud and the voice, this is my beloved son, listened to him. Suddenly, looking around, they no longer saw anyone but Jesus alone with them. And they were coming down from the mountain. He charged them not to relate what had been seen to anyone, except when the Son of Man had risen from the dead. They kept the matter to themselves, questioning what rising from the dead meant. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Peter's response, it is good that we are here. It is good that we are here. Little did we know about a year ago that as we attended church or other functions, that in a matter of days, that would be taken away from us. That most of us went into a quarantine, not knowing when we would get out of it. We're still in it, but it's a little better, of course. Wondering what we're going to do in the future. We couldn't go anywhere. So that phrase, it was good to be here, might have only reflected the fact that we were at home. And for some families, I think, and a lot of people after a little while, we got a little stir crazy. Directory I live, we have four people. We took turns cooking. One gentleman, though, was from India, so whatever he cooked, we called out that night for carry-out. But I think about that phrase, and what I like about it is that Peter, after seeing what went on, how things were transpiring, and this spectacular event of the transfiguration, he had to do something. He had to be in that present moment to be able to say that. That he stopped, saw what was happening, and was able to realize it, digest it, and appreciate it. Just how often do we just keep going on in life, not stopping, not to appreciate what we have, where we are, what we're doing? Because we're always thinking, when will the next thing? When will we get back to the normal? Which all of us like to get there. But in some way and somehow, we know that what's happening now is we have to stop for moments to appreciate what God is doing for us. And that's what Peter teaches us today. I like Abraham also. Abraham is put to a very big test in the God in the first reading today. And the fact that in the midst of all that went on, God promises him all these things, he's still able to respond to the Lord, yes, I will do. I'm just going to wait for the beast to eat it for a second. Thanks. Thank you. That Abraham is able to be, be in that moment. And when he's in that moment, he'll do whatever the Lord asks him to do. See, that's what the present moment is. We're able to surrender, able to really reflect. I have to say, my friends, that's
the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made, for us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary, and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. I confess one baptism for the remission of sins. I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
So as we share our prayers and thoughts with our God, let us do so as we turn to him this day.
That the church will stand before the world without stain or blemish, holy and obedient to God's word, we pray,
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the whole world, that war, hunger, division, illness, and economic hardship may be transfigured and become a time of grace, salvation, and peace, we pray,
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who are alienated from the church, that in this season of reconciliation they may return to Christ, we pray,
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who are burdened with difficult circumstances in their life, that they may experience the transfiguring power of God, we pray,
Lord, hear our prayer.
For Wilbur Zink Sr., whose intentions are being offered in this Eucharist, we pray,
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for those personal petitions, we now offer in silence. We pray,
Lord, hear our prayer.
Share these in our prayers through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
And we have just two announcements. The second collection this weekend is for the Parish Capital Campaign, and we thank you for your continued support.
participles are first with your hands, for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and of all his will of the church.
May the sacrifice, O Lord, be prayed, cleanse us of our fault, sanctify the faithful in body and mind, for the celebration of the Paschal Feast. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
And lift them up the Lord.
Let us return to the Lord our God. It is right and just, our duty and salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord and Holy Father, eternal God. For after he took the disciples of his coming and death, on the holy mountain, he manifested to them his glory, to show, even by testimony of all, the prophets, that the passion leads to the glory of the resurrection. And so the powers of heaven worship him constantly on earth, and when your majesty without end be acclaimed. Similar way when supper ended, he took a chalice and once more. humbly commend to your mercy, and breathe at last from the womb of corruption, you make fully into a new creation, and will sing to you with gladness the thanksgiving of Christ, who lives in all eternity. Through him, with him, in him, O God, Almighty Father, in unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Peace be with you to all those viewing online. The act of spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you're already there and I unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
Thank you.
receive these glorious mysteries, we make thanksgiving to you, O Lord, for allowing us God's still here on earth to be partakers even now of the heavenly banquet. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May the blessing of the Lord come upon you, guide you, and help you, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Let us go in the peace of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Have a blessed afternoon, everyone.
You too, Father.